This is the third video pertaining to a vertical motion problem. In this video, I'd like to answer the following question. How long after takeoff does it take for the rocket to reach 675 feet? Well, to answer this question, we need to solve the following equation for t. Now, notice I've replaced h of t with 675. Remember, h of t represents the position of the rocket at any given value of time t. So we know the position of the rocket. The rocket is 675 feet above the ground, so we need to solve for t to figure out the times when the rocket is at this height. Now we can solve for t two ways. We can graph both sides of the equation, and the intersection of our graphs will represent our solution, or we can use the quadratic formula. I think I'm going to start with the graphical solution. So on your TI graphing calculator, we're going to enter the left and right-hand side of this equation. So my y1 will be negative 16t squared plus 225t plus 25, and my y2 will be 675. So this would be a good time to take out your TI graphing calculator. Okay, so for y1, I will enter what you see. Negative 16, we'll use x squared. Plus 225, plus 25. And for y2, we're going to use 675. Now, if I were to graph this, I'll probably get something that doesn't look right. And that's because my window is not correct. Notice this y2 is 675, so my y max has to be at least 675. A good way to select the proper window would be to press second, table, and let's see what happens. When x is 0, my y is 25. So when x is 0, y is 25, or at time 0, the rocket's 25 feet in the air. Now, if we scroll down a little bit, you'll notice when time is 8 seconds, the rocket's 800 feet in the air. At 9 seconds, it's 754 feet in the air. So you can see as time increases, the rocket gets higher, but it looks like it peaks out around x equals 7 or 816 feet. All right, so the rocket's going up and then it starts to come down and it looks like it hits the ground somewhere in between 14 and 15 seconds, right? Because when my y goes negative, that means the rocket is below the ground. So realistically, y is probably going to equal 0 when the rocket hits the ground. So for my x min and max, I'm probably going to go from 0 to, say, 15. And for my y max, I'll probably go to from 0 to, say, 900. Even though you don't see 900 here, it looks like the rocket peaks out around 816. I'm going to use 900 just to be safe. So press window. And for X min, I'm going to use 0. And my X max, we're going to use 15. My scale will be 1, so I'm going to count by 1s along the X axis. For my Y min, I'm going to start at 0. And my Y max, I'm going to use 900. Oops. Okay, so I have my X min at 0, X max is 15. So that's really saying 0 to 15 seconds. I'm counting by 1s. For my Y min, I'm going to start at 0 and go up to 900. But I don't want to count by 1s. I don't want to go from 0 to 900 by 1. So let's maybe we'll count by 20. Okay, I'm going to press graph. Okay, that looks okay. And you can see my curve intersects twice. And you can see here I'm counting by 1s. And here I'm counting by 20s. You know, I'm thinking, you know what? I just want to see what happens if I change my y scale to, say, 45. So instead of counting by 20, I'm going to count by 45. I press graph. The curve is the same, except now you can see these tick marks aren't spaced out so closely. And now what we need to do is find where this intersects, right? The intersection is going to be our solution to this question. And it looks like we're going to have two answers. So let's start. We're going to press second, calc, and we're looking for the intersection. That's number 5. Now it says, okay, where's your first curve? So you can see I'm on the parabola right now, so I'll press enter. Now it says second curve. Okay, I'm on my second curve. That's the straight line. I press enter. Now it says guess. Well, I can either guess somewhere over here or at the second intersection. So I'm going to start on the left, so I'm going to arrow over a few times to get closer to this intersection, and now I'll press enter. So it's telling me the intersection's at 4.0625 for x and y 675. So really this is saying at 4.0625 seconds, the rocket is 675 feet in the air. So as an ordered pair, my solution to this equation is 4.0625, 675. However, remember, we have two solutions. This is just the first intersection. The rocket's on its way up. It takes 4.0625 seconds to get 675 feet in the air. Then the rocket continues going up and then starts to come down. So we need to figure out what this intersection is. So again, we press second, calc. We're looking for the intersection. Okay, my first curve is the parabola. I just want to make sure I'm on it. Yeah, that's the parabola. Press enter. Second curve is the straight line. Fine. And my guess, well, I'm not going to guess over here. I'm going to probably have to move the cursor to the second intersection. So I press the arrow key several times. And as I get closer to this intersection, okay, I think that's close enough. I'll press enter. And now it's telling me at 10 seconds, the rocket's 675 feet. So my second solution as an ordered pair is 10, 675. Again, on the way up, the rocket takes 4.0625 seconds to get 675 feet in the air. The rocket continues to go up and then starts to come down or descend. And at 10 seconds, the rocket again is at 675 feet in the air. So back to our original question, how long does it take after takeoff does it take for the rocket to reach 675 feet? Well, we have two answers. It took 4.0625 seconds, and it also took 10 seconds to reach that altitude. So we've just solved this equation graphically. In the next video, I'd like to use the quadratic formula to solve this equation for t. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.